Welcome to VCC Libraries' two-part video tutorial on Ovid Medline. Medline is a database that indexes articles from academic journals related to medicine, nursing, pharmacy, dentistry, allied health, and other related fields. And Ovid is a platform that provides access to Medline and other databases. Its interface is designed for advanced searches and for systematic literature reviews. Medline can also be accessed through EBSCO and PubMed, but this two-part tutorial will focus on Ovid. In this video, we'll translate concepts from a sample research question into subject headings, and then add those subject headings to our search history. In part two, we'll supplement our subject headings with keywords, and then finally combine our subject heading and keyword searches from our search history into a single search. We'll start from the Ovid Medline homepage. Make sure to access Ovid Medline through the VCC Library website. If you're off campus, you'll need to log in to your VCC account. If you need help, check out our video titled Off Campus Access to Online Library Resources. We can see Ovid Medline defaults to the Advanced Search tab. Also note that Ovid Medline 1996 to present has been selected automatically. Click Change to select a different resource. You can select a different database altogether or choose a different section of Medline to search, for example, 1946 to present. But I'll press Cancel to stick with the default. Now, our first step is to divide our research topic into key concepts so that we can search one concept at a time, and then later we'll combine the concepts into a single search. For this video, I'll use the sample research question, "Can hypnosis be used to relieve pain?" We can break this question down into two basic concepts, hypnosis and pain relief. Now we're ready to translate these concepts into subject headings. Ovid Medline uses medical subject headings known as MeSH, which is a comprehensive set of consistent terms that can help us find what we're looking for. To translate the concept hypnosis into a MeSH subject heading, type hypnosis into the search box. Leave map term to subject heading checked and click search. We find hypnosis is a MeSH subject heading. We can click on the word hypnosis to see where the concept falls in the hierarchy of subject headings. There are two narrower terms nested underneath the heading hypnosis. To expand our search to include these narrower terms, we can check the box for explode. Now I'll click continue, which brings us to a page that gives us the option to limit our search using subheadings. Be careful, subheadings often exclude relevant results, so we're not going to select any subheadings today. I'll just click the Continue button, which will automatically include all subheadings in our search. We can expand our search history, and we'll find exp hypnosis forward slash. The forward slash tells us hypnosis is a subject heading. EXP is code that means the subject heading has been exploded to include its narrower terms. We'll be using our search history later in this tutorial to combine our searches into one complete search, but for now, we'll move on to our next concept. Our second concept is pain relief. I'll type pain relief into the search box and click search. Note that map term to subject heading is still checked. We can see pain management is a MeSH subject heading. I already know I want to include any narrower terms, so I'll select explode. And I also want to include all subheadings, so I'll check the box next to include all subheadings, then I'll click continue. Now, pain management has appeared in our search history right underneath hypnosis. Fantastic. In part two of this tutorial, we will supplement our subject headings with keywords, combine our various subject headings and keywords into a single complete search, and finally learn how to filter, view, and save our results.